okay. You're going to hear a lot of this four-letter word coming out of my mouth sooner or later. So here it goes. Snow.
Oh, that's not a word I want to hear, but I know a lot of people are looking forward to seeing lots of it this year. Bill Steffen says Mother Nature is going to deliver, and one of the people, one a couple of the people that want to see a lot of snow, are actually here on our set today.
Exactly. Matt Chapman, a volunteer with the West Michigan Ski Patrols at Cannonsburg, Pando, and across many of the Nordic trails. He's here along with our favorite zoologist, Bert Vescolani. I believe me, you know, you recognize Bert because he is the guy that just a couple of weeks ago brought a...
A friend.
A python into the station and surprised me with it as a little Halloween treat.
And you did fantastic.
Thank you. I even touched the snake.
It was a treat.
But today we're talking about something else that starts with an S. Not snakes, but snow.
Right. And, you know, Cannonsburg is a fantastic place for people to come out and ski and learn and play around a little bit and get comfortable with stuff. But the ski patrollers that are out there do hundreds of hours of training and planning. And we have doctors and lawyers and business owners.
Zoo directors.
Students and zoo directors.
Exactly. Yeah.
All out there helping out and trying to keep people safe. And unfortunately, sometimes people do get hurt. And when they do get hurt, well, we're the first responders. We help them get to the right people and get the right care and support. So we're doing the ski swap to help support all of those efforts and do what
Which is really great. I didn't really realize that the ski patrollers, you guys are volunteers.
That's
which
great.
Is really amazing.
Well, you want to get more people out for the season. It just makes for a better atmosphere. Cannonsburg has a lot of new and great things going on right now.
Right.
But in order to get out, people need the equipment. Of course, there's rentals there, but you can own them. It can be pricey, but the ski swap is an opportunity for families to get it. Can you just tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, certainly. We've got some great equipment going on this weekend. It's the 40th year for the ski swap. We've brought in equipment vendors from all over the state of Michigan. So we've got some brand new skis and snowboards. A lot of times people hear the word swap and they think it's older stuff. That's not really the case. We do have some gently used equipment, but we've got a lot of brand new skis, snowboards. I've got a snowboard here that's still in the wrapping with bindings for $230. So that's a great deal
to keep
your family and your kids going.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you're looking for an early Christmas present for somebody, maybe let them unwrap it as soon as the snow gets here.
Yes.
I got to ask about safety, because I know you guys are safety is priority number one. You check all the bindings, you make sure that everything is up to standard before people go away with it?
Well, they do. Yeah, I mean, everything's looked at. We wouldn't sell anything that was unsafe, and all the equipment, especially the new equipment, obviously is ready to go. But, you know, we always advise people when they bring in their stuff to get a custom fit for themselves. Mm-hmm. And we'll do some of that at the ski swap and help them pick the right skis, you know, size and so on and so forth, weight requirements and so on. But, you know, a place like, you know, our ski shop at Cannonsburg or other ski shops can help you with a little bit more detail and make sure the bindings are the right. If you're a beginner, they want to be a little looser. If you're more advanced skier or racer, a little bit tighter. And so you do all that to make sure that you're safe. And helmets.
Helmets are very important.
Helmets,
I know.
And snowboarders, wrist guards. I mean, those are the two things that we see the most out of Cannonsburg. And those are things, you know, broken wrists can happen pretty easily.
Absolutely. Just fall the wrong way. I've had it happen myself when I was a teenager. I've been going to Cannonsburg since I was a kid.
Yeah.
It's a great place, but this year is a little bit different. You have new ownership at Cannonsburg.
Yeah.
What are some of the different things that people would see when they go out to the resort?
First thing, right away when you pull up, you're going to notice that the entire lodge has been spruced up. A lot of the sidewalks have been replaced. They've done a lot of landscaping in front, repainted all the buildings, all the lift towers have been repainted inside and out. It's just cleaner, a lot newer, fresher face. They have installed a couple new runs, made it a little easier to get back from the triple area over to the lodge. They put a new handle toe lift. As Bert mentioned, the magic carpet will be installed and hopefully up and running before the snow comes.
It's a great way to get kids out there
for this size.
Hey, I'm eyeing these because my
little pink ones.
I think you're ready.
We
need to put her in.
So fast.
You know, it's interesting because we get, you know, Bill Steffen came up with the winter weather prediction last week, and it looks like we're going to get probably at least a foot and a half more snow this year than we had last year. And some people groan about it.
Right.
But the key is finding a sport you like to do when it's snowy, because guess what? We get a bumper crop of snow here in West Michigan.
You know, and the snow here in West Michigan is so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, I lived in Chicago for years, and Chicago snow is not beautiful. The snow here is absolutely beautiful. And if it's going to be that pretty, you may as well come out to Cannonsburg and have... There's trails back there. There's all kinds of things to do. Mm-hmm. And cross-country skiing at the county parks is a fantastic thing to do.
Yeah.
So there's so many options for outdoor sports. Snowshoeing, you know, get some snowshoes and trek around. It's a lot of fun.
Having that equipment, the right equipment to get out and enjoy it so you're not freezing when you're out there is important.
Right. Winter can
you have clothing and apparel and hats, gloves, everything is
perfect
at the swap. It's not
outfit.
Just skis and
there
snowboard.
You go.
So,
you
know, and really, that's a great point, because even if you're not interested in the least of skiing or snowboarding or anything else, come out to take advantage of the deals they have on this apparel. This is brand new. $100 off what you pay retail.
Or more. Yeah. And, you know, the thing is so many kids start skiing and they grow. Well, my kids don't grow as fast as they
they're
challenged with this genetics, but a lot of families are grown pretty quickly. Their kids are growing. So you'll be in these for a couple years, and the ski swap's a great way to do it, affordable way to do it, and a great opportunity to get new stuff and slightly used.
Mm-hmm. Well, I can vouch for the lodge itself. There's food, there's events a lot of times, and there's a bar even. I know that there's
adult beverages up at the top.
So even if you don't ski and your kids want to, it's a great place to hang out.
It really is. Well, thank you so much. That's coming up, and it's Saturday and Sunday. So
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m., Sunday 11 to 2 up at Cannonsburg. And we do have a little bit of time yet today. If you still have some skis in your garage that you want to sell, get them in the swap. Get up to Cannonsburg tonight before 8 o'clock.
Great. Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thanks
very,
for
very
coming
helpful.
In.
We'll put that on our website, too, to make it easy to find. So.
You know what I like to see, Bert, on the ski hill? Because I know we won't have any reptiles out there.
You're safe.
Just a cucumber-like panda bear.
Yeah, we do have lots of fuzzy. Exactly.
We'll be right back. Stay with us.
This is 8 West.